You're listening to IBGR, our call sign for the Internet Business Growth Radio Network. The broadcast frequency is our URL, and that's IBGR.network. We provide live and record shows 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, on what an entrepreneur or small business consultant needs to grow their operation from zero to big. How big? Up to you. IBGR focuses on the 180 million English-speaking small business owners around the world in four major markets: North America, Australia, Oceania, the Indian subcontinent, and United Kingdom, Europe, and Africa. All of these six-hour cycles are delivered in six major themes: strategy, operations, sales, people, ownership, and consulting. The first four tracks, strategy, operations, sales, and people, are the day-to-day tactical issues all entrepreneurs face. The fifth track, ownership, takes the conversation to the next level. How can an owner working in the business make the transition to an executive of a multi-million dollar firm by working on it? Our last track, consulting, is for our brothers and sisters with the same mission as IBGR, helping small business owners grow. I bet you didn't know that 57% of everybody on the planet is employed by a small business owner. Let's team up and help business owners increase generational wealth for themselves and their family while creating good jobs in their local community. Our team has over seven decades of helping and building businesses. We have turned those years of experience into radio shows and downloadable tools that any entrepreneur, whether you're an independent contractor, solopreneur, or business owner, can apply immediately. All you have to do is download, listen, apply, and engage. Download the show notes that address current issues in your business. Listen to the show live or as a podcast. Apply the information and tools. Engage us with your experience and feedback. And if you really want to maximize your time spent with IBGR, join our community and have access to our toolbox. This just scratches the surface of what you will receive every day at IBGR. The opportunity to grow with us is only limited by your imagination and persistence. Let's grow together and put the world back to work. Thanks for listening.
IBGR Network provides actionable information and practices the team concept using the Thrive Model. The Thrive Model teaches business owners and leaders how to view business with a heartfelt mindset, which is deeper than the fixed and growth mindset. To thrive from the heart requires thought, heart feeling, relationships, intention, vitality, and enrichment. Heartfelt mindsets are actively engaged and involved in contribution and focused on internal and external thriving. A show that provides strategies for women to thrive from the heart. The Women of Business Thriving Show with Dr. Tracie Hines Lashley begins now.
Hello, world. I am back. I am Dr. Tracie Hines Lashley, and welcome to another session of Women of Business Thriving. Yes, on the IBGR Network. I am so excited. You know, it's a new year. New beginning, fresh ideas are spurring up, and we just always need to stay focused. So I am the Executive Chief Elevation Officer of the Leaders Innovative Growth Solutions, and I am also the CEO of Bossed Up Lead Hers Incorporated, which is a nonprofit organization for women. Yes, you see the relation, women, women, women. I love educating and working with women. So if you have some ideas that you want to bring to the show, if you think about things, you're like, oh, maybe we should try this, or you want to collab with me? Come on, let's do it. You know, I am all about teamwork, all about collaboration. So that is what you will hear a lot on my shows. And one of the most crucial aspects of it is we get to show the world that women can work together. Yes, we can. No matter what people are saying, we can do this. And I wanted to have a show that relates that and shows the different areas where we are great, as well as areas that we can help each other grow. And on this station, I love it because we help each other. we are all entrepreneurs, and it's just exciting to be able to grab some tips and tricks and strategies from others. So if you have not done so, download our app. Yes, it's a fabulous tool to use to stay in touch with us and connect and reach out. And if you hear on the shows about something that someone else has and you're like, well, you won't provide input or you have a question, guess what? You can do that. So we are going to be talking about the importance and also some strategies on visions and goals. Yes, I know you know all about vision and goals. You're aware of it. Great. There might be some information that you may not have known. So grab your pen and paper or grab your iPad or phone or whatever and jot down some notes. So let's talk about what it means to have a clear vision. You want to know where you're going. So the objective of this show is to outline the requirements for business success, which also serves as a strategic plan. And the vision statement also serves as an employee guide when challenges arise. You want to make sure you have something for them to follow and something to be like, oh, okay. You know, I need to stay focused on that. And you also want to ensure that you have goals outlined, obtainable goals, not just some things you just threw out there. So we're going to break the goals down for you so you can make sure that you have a guide to go by. And also you want to have targets. So we always have these goals. First of all, we want to make them smart. If you don't know about smart goals, you will know after this show. So keep listening. So one thing is you want to have targets that they meet along the way, like milestones for your goals. So you want to make sure that not only have you been strategic when you're outlining your goals, but also, and I will say this again, you hear me say this a lot, have your team involved. Look, there is nothing worse than you coming up with all this nice, great material and make it all nice and pretty like some people might want to say. And then your team gets in like, oh, what is this? And who did you talk to get this done? And then all the little time that you have spent, well, it might be a whole lot of time that you spent on this material has gone to waste. So time is something you cannot get back. So, and you are also a resource. So make sure that you include your team when you're doing this. Don't do everything in silo in a black hole. Because guess what? Yeah, all your time spent will go down into a hole and you got to start all over again. And what? You're going to have to involve your team. So do you want that? I don't want that for you. Okay. So let's make sure we include our team. We're trying to outline everything for us. And some of the issues that we see is, first of all, we don't have our mission together. We don't have a mission statement. Or it's not one where you're aligning your vision and your goals to. You can have a mission, then you have your vision, you have your goals. And if they don't coincide with each other, it's not going to work. So you want to make sure that you have something that flows well and will help you meet along the way. Another thing is our goals are not written with the SMART criteria: specific, measurable, achievable, realistic, and time-based. This also, if you listen to one of my shows from last season, I talked about this when you're dealing with employees. So you make sure that your employees have SMART objectives and goals. But guess what? Your business also needs to have SMART objectives and goals. Yes, they must be SMART. That's why I said, let's talk about vision and goals, and we got to be smart about it. And you also want to have clear business goals outlined. And targets identified, as I was stating before, because goals, that's the big picture. But you want to have targets. And another thing about targets, milestones, whatever you want to call them, is they, you know, celebrate them along the way. You want to keep your employees motivated. And you know what? You want to also keep yourself motivated. So as you're meeting these business targets or milestones, you get, those are your quick wins. You're like, yes, I did that. So, did y'all see that? We won. We did this. We made it. We hit that target. Let's celebrate. Even if it's, hey, you guys can get a quick little 59, which that's what we call it with the government system. You know, we can't give people an hour off of work, so we can give them a 59. So call it something like that. Maybe you say, hey, well, we're going to have some downtime and let's order pizza. Or let's just go out for a nightcap. However you celebrate, just be reasonable and responsible with it. So those are things that I'm excited because winning excites me. I mean, we have to fail as well, you know, fail forward. So, but I love those quick wins. I love celebrating. And who doesn't like to eat? Okay. I know I do. And I am sure your employees love to eat too. So just think of some things that will excite them and keep them motivated and want to keep reaching these targets. And as we go along the show, we're also going to be talking about creating a clear vision for your business that your employees will be excited about. Not only your employees, also you as a business owner and your customer. And you want to make sure, I'm going to show you how to outline a clear and objective goals. Because you want to make sure you're headed in the right direction. And you want to also ensure targets are identified to assist with reaching these company goals. So we're going to talk about that as well. And also creating a business vision board. Yeah, you heard me right. We always think about personal vision boards. We have these vision board parties and just living a life, right? Okay. Yeah, all that stuff up there on the screen or on your board or on your wall or wherever you store it, on your phone, wherever. Guess what? You need to have that for your business as well. Am I crazy? No, I'm not. What do you see? What do you envision for your business for the year? You know how you get excited about your personal vision board, but get excited about your business vision board as well. I know I do. And I just started doing this last year. And I was like, you know, that's pretty cool. Having a vision board for my business. Did you think about that one? Probably not. So yeah, just think about it. And that, guess what? You really want to involve your team. Now, if you do a business vision board without your leadership and primary staff, okay, we're going to have some issues. And let me know how you're doing with that. You know, like I said, download the app and chat with me. Let me know how your vision board is coming along. And as we go throughout the year, just say, hey, that vision board really worked. It really helped me. I really would like to know. And you also want to talk about, you know, how to conduct strategic sessions with leadership and staff. As well as you must ensure to start with a clear mission statement. We're going to touch a little bit on that, but not so much. But you want to ensure that you have a mission statement that is clear. Your staff, your leadership knows about it and they understand it and they're excited about that as well. Because if not, you might have some challenges as you go along the way. So we are going to take a quick break.